Hello, this is Tom Mack, Technical Support Specialist for Bacharach. Today I'm going to talk about correcting a stack temperature error on the Fyrite InTech. A very similar procedure works on its retired predecessors, the Fyrite Tech 50 and the Fyrite Tech 60, both of which are still widely used today. A stack temperature error, or T-STK error, doesn't occur often, but when it does, it can be pretty inconvenient. Fortunately, this condition can be quickly diagnosed and easily remedied in most cases. And it can be even done on location with a couple of tools you probably already have handy. The probe assembly has a yellow thermocouple connector on the end of the brown thermocouple wire. During normal use, the thermocouple wiring inside the connector may become loose, shorted, or even broken, causing a T-STK error on the InTech analyzer, or a blank T-STK reading on the Fyrite Tech 60 and Tech 50. In either case, it indicates a problem. See, the probe assembly is used for sampling stack gases as they exit the combustion device being tested, the furnace, boiler, for example. In addition, the probe assembly also measures temperature of these gases inside the stack. Both of these readings, the gas sample itself and its temperature, are critical for proper combustion analysis. Unfortunately, if there is a problem with the T-STK thermocouple, the stack gas temperature won't be measured and the combustion analyzer can't provide accurate combustion readings. So what can you do? Well, start your investigation by placing the yellow connector on a table and loosening the two screws that attach the cover to the connector. Then carefully remove this cover. Slide the strain release spring out of the way, then inspect the interior of the connector to identify any broken, loose, or shorted wires. The connector on the newer InTech probes uses metal plates that clamp down on the two individual thermocouple wires. On the older Tech 50 and Tech 60, the thermocouple wires were simply secured around the individual screws. Other than this physical difference of how the wires are secured to the connector, the process itself is the same for both old style and new style connectors. If the wires are loose, simply tighten the terminal plate or tighten the individual terminal screws. Be sure the red wire is attached to the minus terminal, which is the wider blade, and the yellow wire is attached to the positive terminal, which is the narrower blade. If the wires are damaged, loosen the terminal plate, then remove the wires and any fragments from underneath. For the older connector, loosen the two individual terminal screws, remove the wires and any fragments from under the screws, and then proceed the same way. Cut the two wires so both are the same length. Note that you may have to strip back a small amount of the brown outer casing. Just be careful not to nick either of the two thermocouple wires within. Next, strip approximately 1/4 to 3/8 of an inch of the insulation from each thermocouple wire. Then install the wires under the terminal plates and tighten the screws. As before, older connectors will have two screw terminals instead of the single terminal plate. In this case, a pair of round nose pliers will definitely help in getting a clean wire curve for wrapping around the individual terminal screws. Finally, be sure that the red wire is attached to the minus terminal, the wider blade, and the yellow wire is attached to the positive terminal, the narrower blade. Verify that the wires are secure in their respective terminals and the strip portions are fully under the terminal plate. For the older style connectors, ensure that the strip portions are fully and securely seated between the respective terminal bases and the terminal screws. In either case, ensure the two wires cannot short against each other. Finally, slide the strain release spring back into position and replace the cover using the two cover screws. That's it. Assuming no other errors or faults exist, and assuming you didn't defeat the keyed connector by forcing it into the analyzer backwards, the T-STK error should be gone, you should see a valid T-STK reading, and your analyzer should be functioning normally. Remember, without the T-STK measurement, you're not going to get reliable combustion readings. The InTech, Fyrite Tech 50, and Fyrite Tech 60 all use the same probe assembly, including the T-STK thermocouple. For minor thermocouple maintenance after a T-STK error, be sure to use this tech tip. With a couple of basic tools that you already have, you can use this information to get yourself out of a T-STK jam, because it's quick and it's easy to do. Two more reasons why Bacharach is the measurable difference.